Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning class, how are you?
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning ma'am.
I'm fine.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, before the lesson begins, let's pray based on our religion. Pray, start. Finish. Let me take attendance first. Please say present when I call your name. Olivia?
Present, ma'am.
Aldo?
Present, ma'am.
Budi?
Present, ma'am.
Inaya?
Present, ma'am.
Karisma?
Present, ma'am.
Good, everybody is present. Anybody knows what we are going to learn today?
Plantae, ma'am.
That's right. Today's topic is plantae. As for the learning objective that must be achieved in the material about plantae, there are to know the general characteristic of kingdom plantae, to know the kingdom plantae classification, and to be able to distinguish the characteristic of the three division of the kingdom plantae classification. Okay, now look at the picture on the board. What are the characteristic of the kingdom plantae? Anybody knows the answer?
Have a cell, ma'am.
Anyone else want to try?
It's an organism of tautroph, ma'am.
Well, your answer are correct. The characteristic of the kingdom plantae there are: first, has a cell wall made of cellulose. Second, is an autotrophic organism because it has chlorophyll which function in the process of photosynthesis. Third, eukaryotic organism which have a nuclear cell membrane. And then multicellular, which has many cells. And last, can store food reserve in the form of starch. In the kingdom plantae, there are three classification of plantae based on their phylum. Anyone knows what?
I want to answer, ma'am. Kingdom plantae consists of three divisions. There are bryophyta, pteridophyta, and spermatophyta.
Good job, thank you, Inaya. Look at the picture. This is bryophyta. Bryophyta or most plants are type of plant that don't have true organs such as roots, stem, and leaf. And these bryophyta don't have transport vessels such as xylem and phloem. They only have rhizoid that can come. As in the picture, the classification of bryophyta there are first bryopsida or leaf lichen. In Indonesia, lumut daun. Bryopsida in a true lichen due to change in plant form in plant with the root, stem, and leaf. They live in a group and form a thick expanse. Example, sphagnum. Second, hepaticopsida or liverwort. In Indonesia, lumut hati. Hepaticopsida is still in the form of talu or talapita. Apart from that, they also punch and form a zygote. Example, Marcantia polymorpha. And the last, Antoceratopsida or hornwort, in Indonesia, lumut tanduk. This type of moss has an elongated capsule that grows with horn forms its gametophyte, commonly referred to as Antoceratopsida. Example, Antoceros levis. Nah, itu merupakan ciri dan klasifikasi dari lumut atau bryophyta. Okay, now we enter the second division, namely pteridophyta. Pteridophyta or coral forms have transport tissue or corms and true organ. But pteridophyta don't have seed. Forms are a type chromophyte with spora, have true root, stem, and leaf, and reproduce by spora. Pteridophyta are more developed than bryophyta because they already have a xylem and phloem vessels. Anybody knows classification of pteridophyta?
I want to answer, ma'am. Pteridophyta is divided into four types. There are pteropsida, psilopsida, equisetum, and the last is Lycopsida.
Good job, Karisma. Your answer is correct. Okay, I will explain one by one. First, true names or Therapsida in Indonesia, Paku Sejati. Therapsida means this type of fern has true roots, stem, and leaf. The young leaf will grow curled. Among other types of ferns, this type has the most species. Example for Therapsida is Adiantum cuneatum. You can look at the picture. This is Adiantum cuneatum. Second, unseen nails or Psilopsida in Indonesia, Paku Purba. Psilopsida is a plant that is almost extinct. Among other types of ferns, this type is the least species. Example from Psilopsida is Rhynia major. You can look this picture. This is Rhynia major. And then horsetail or Equisetum in Indonesia, Paku ekor kuda. This type of fern has a stem shaped like a horse tail. They only produce one type of spora or homospora. Habitat Equisetum is in subtropical and humid area. Example from Equisetum is Equisetum sp. And this is a picture of Equisetum sp. And last, wire nails or Lycopsida in Indonesia, Paku Kawar. Wire nails or Lycopsida is a type of name plant that is heterospora or can produce two kinds of spora. The gamete of it has no chlorophyll and consists of two gametes, bisexual and unisexual. And this is Lycopodium sp. Nah, itu merupakan ciri dan klasifikasi dari Pteridophyta. Okay, now we enter the last division is Spermatophyta. Okay, I will explain one by one. First, gymnosperm. What is mean by open seed is a plant with seeds that are not covered by ovule. The characteristic include has a root from riding, has a no true inters, has narrow, thick, and stiff leaves, has a cone-shaped reading apparatus called or strobilus or conifers, and have pollen in male strobilus and egg in female strobilus. Second, closed-seed plants or angiosperm. Different from gymnosperm with seeds that are not covered with ovule, angiosperm have seeds that are contained in the ovules. You can also see the characteristic from the shape of the leaf bones, which are fingers, pinnate, parallel, or curved. Then the leaves are white and flattened. Usually live as sharp trees, herbs, and has true flowers. Angiosperm are further divided into two classes. There are two pieces of seeds or dicotyl, and then one piece of seeds or monocot. Okay, that is classification of kingdom plantae. Jadi kita udah mengetahui ya bahwa kingdom plantae terdiri dari tiga divisi, yaitu Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, and Spermatophyta. Okay, any question before we end the class?
Nothing, ma'am.
Well, for homework, I want you to make a comparison table of the characteristic of Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, and Spermatophyta. Find as many difference in the characteristic of the three division. Okay, I will see you again next week. Don't forget to do your homework. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Have a nice day.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.